Hello, my name is Lo G, and today is going to be another example of a Patreon lesson. Whenever I get into a new topic, I'll always devote an entire lesson to songs that actually use this sound so you can hear it in action. The topic today is the sound of a four chord, which is simply the sound that's built off of the fourth note of the key, and I wanted to do this one because it is an extremely popular sound, especially in the modern era, and is used in a wide variety of genres, which you'll hear in this video. Hopefully you enjoy. I'll see you in the next one. What's happening, everybody? Today is the day where we go over a bunch of songs that use the four chord in a variety of ways. I have a ton of songs that we're going to do, so let's just get started. The first couple songs that we're going to use or go through are going to be songs that feature the sharp four, the color note of the four chord. So again, if let's say we're in the key of G and C is our four chord, right? The sharp four will be here with the fret right behind five. The sharp four of the four chord is the seven of the whole key, right? F sharp, which would be the seven of G, the note right behind G. So keep that in mind. We're gonna go through a bunch of songs that use this note in a variety of ways. Some songs just nail it out of nowhere. Other songs have the note inside of like a riff that's happening. And other songs use this note or access this note by using some pretend chords. If you remember, the main pretend chord that we've talked about so far that hits this sharp four is when you play a five chord on top of a four chord, right? So if the chord is C, but someone else is playing D, so it sounds like this, right? We have a D chord on top, but C in the bass. Sounds like that. That's always a really easy way to access that sharp four because the third of the five chord, the F sharp in this case, is the sharp four of the four chord. Again, not stuff you have to absolutely memorize right now, but keep it in mind because that will kind of help some of these sounds make more sense. So the first tune that we're going to go through is a classical piece written definitely after 1945. I don't know exactly what year, but this piece is a kind of the lyrical content of this piece has to do with the German concentration camps. Sorry for bringing the mood of the lesson down immediately, but it's a really great piece. It's by a composer named Goretzky. The piece is the second movement of a symphony that he has called Symphony of Sorrowful Songs, and it's just a great example of this massive four chord that contains a ton of different notes, in particular the sharp four. So let me play it real fast. That's the four chord right there. Super, super dense sound. And let's go over exactly what's going on right there. So it's two chords. It's a one chord and then a four chord. Song's in the key of A. So one, if I just play like the bass chords, one and then four, it's pretty much what it is. But what's actually happening is you hear this melody. Right? And what is that? That's A. That's the fifth and seven of A. And then what happens? This note lingers into the next chord, which is a four chord. And the voicing, it's kind of hard to play this exact voicing because they have a full symphony and I only have six strings, but it's something like this. Like a huge chord, a huge four chord that's got, you know, a normal 1-3-5, but also the sharp four and the two happening at the same time. So you can hear this note linger into the next chord as that melody happens. So it's something like this. And then this. Right? So the melody is here, but this note is still ringing out, and you get this huge chord. Let me play that one more time now that we went over that. Check it out. Here's, this one is the one chord right here. That's the sharp four. Still lingering into the next chord. One more time. Crazy, crazy thick chord that you can really only do when you have a bunch of different instruments because you can play a bunch of notes that are next to each other and it sounds really great. I mean, you can kind of, I guess, do this on guitar or you can do this on piano, but with a symphony like that, it sounds amazing. I highly recommend you check this piece out. It's one of the best pieces I've ever heard. Check it out. It's really good. So another one, another kind of classical music sounding. This one is probably not, it's pretty modern, probably written within the past 20 years. This is a composer named Eric Whitaker. This is all choir music. And what's happening here, if I play it, the tune is sort of in the key of E flat. It's not 100% in tune, but let's say it's an E flat. So that means the four chord is going to be A flat, five chord, B flat, one chord E flat, that sort of thing. What you're going to hear in this piece is you're going to hear a four chord, and what they're going to do is they're going to play the sharp four of that and then resolve back into the normal three. So if here's our chord, standard 1-5-3 shape that we've been playing, they're going to play this. The sharp four is up a whole step from the three on the G string, so that's what they're going to play, and then resolve to the three. Right, so sharp four on top, then the three. Then they go to the five and do a similar thing with its four and three. It has a normal four, so it'll sound like this, like a suspended sound that we talked about before. And then back to the four, sharp four on top, resolve to the three. And then the five, four on top, resolve to the three. Really, really popular sound. I'm sure you've heard this before, but it's very effective in a choir. So let's listen to what this sounds like. So here he comes, getting to it. Here we go. Four chord right here with the sharp on top. Five chord. Again, four chord. Five chord. Now listen to this one. Watch this. Super huge, very effective chord. So what was happening right there? Same exact idea, but there were just more notes. Instead of just like that one single little note moving down, they were adding stuff. So instead of just these two, or that one note, it was now two notes moving down. Same thing with the five chord. And then that final big one, what was actually happening? It was a pretend chord. The chord was a four chord. The low register was playing four, but the top register was playing a five chord and then pulling back. So that sounded like this. Right? So the bass is a four, the root of the four chord, but the rest of the notes on top are a literal 1-3-5 of B flat, a five chord. So it sounds like this. The exact voicing is more like this that they're doing on top, like that. Right, again, four in the bass, four of the key in the bass, implying the four chord, but they're playing a five chord on top of it. They're pretending that it's actually 5-4 when it's really just four the whole time. Let me play that one more time so you can check it out. Here's the five. Normal sharp four on top. Normal five. Here's the big one. Watch this. Five chord. Full five chord. And then they finish. Yeah, so that whole time, it's really a four chord happening on the bottom, but they're changing the chord on top with the other voicings, creating this huge, like, suspension. And again, what note do we access when we play a five chord on top of a four chord? We play the four chords, six, two, and sharp four, the sharp four being the main color note that's happening right there, right? Another really great piece that you should check out. This is Eric Whitaker. The song's called Sleep. It's very good. Check it out. It's great. Okay, so now we're going to go through another song that does this exact same thing, but the song is way more popular, and it does it in a more of a rock context. Here's a song. I guarantee you've heard it. This one's in the key of E. So I'm sure you've all heard this. This is Don't Stop Believin'. The verse of the song that we just heard is 1-5-6-4. We actually don't care about that part. We care about the next part that's about to happen. So let me play a little bit. For a smile they can share the night. Watch this. It goes on and on, this part coming up right here. Here we go. Let's just listen to that part. So the song's in the key of E. That part that comes in right there is A, so like an A chord, normal A. But listen to what's happening in the background, right? You have those moving notes, bum, bum, in the melody, as well as bum, bum, happening in the arrangement. What is happening right there? It's literally the same thing that we just heard in that choir piece. It's a four chord, but they're pretending for a moment that there's a five chord happening. So they're playing a five chord on top of a four chord. Let me show you what that looks like. Here's A, right? I'm going to use the open A string because that's the four of this key. So I'm playing the open A. Here's a normal A chord on top, right? 1-3-5. That's just like left shape 1-3-5. What are they playing? A five chords 1-3-5. With the A in the bass, a five chord on top of a four chord, pretending that it's a five, and then they move back. And then they play a one chord, so it's like 5-4, 5-1. That's what they're playing. If I played literally those chords, it would sound like this. But that's not what they're doing. They're playing those chords, but keeping A, the 4, ringing the whole time. So it sounds like this. Right? It's the same exact thing as we just heard in the choir piece, just a more kind of rock, maybe slightly cornier version of that. But yes, that is happening in the song. If you ever want to hear this type of move or heavy emphasis of a 4 chord, especially the sharp 4 of a 4 chord, Journey loves this sound. It's in so many of their songs. So whoever's writing their music loves this sound and knows how to access it, because that's exactly what's happening. So that's Journey. Another song, the next song is going to be another rock group. This is a tune called No Way Back, No Way Back by the Foo Fighters. And this one, same key, it's in the key of E again, and the verse nails A, the 4 chord, right? And the very first note of the melody is gonna be the sharp 4, the very first note. So again, how do we find the sharp 4? Of course, we just walk up the scale based on the 4 chord, 1, 2, 3, not normal 4, sharp 4, that's the note that's in this key. Or we can just think, what key are we in? E, the 7 of the key, which is a fret back from E, the 7 of the key is the sharp 4 of the 4 chord. You know, we've been talking about this whole time. So check out this verse. This is, again, No Way Back by the Foo Fighters. The very first note that he sings is the sharp 4. And you can hear the vibe that's created when that happens. So again, key of A, or excuse me, E. The 4 chord is A. It's going to start on E right here. E becomes the A. Sharp 4. Sharp 4. Back to 1 chord. Back to the 4. There it is. So right off the bat, the first note you hear when it switches to that 4 chord is the sharp 4 on top. Right? Right off the bat. Super effective, super significant and different sound that is entirely created by targeting that color note of the 4 chord. People do it all the time. That's a great example of it. Here's an example of the same sort of thing, but the sharp 4 is kind of embedded in a riff. This song is in the key of G, this next song that we're going to go through. So the 4 chord is C, and the riff sounds like this. So this is Head Over Heels by Tears for Fears. And again, what key are we in? We're in the key of G. So that melody feels like this. It feels like 1-7-6-5-6-4 of the key of G. But what's the first chord they play? Not G. C, the 4 chord. So you're hearing all of that stuff over a 4 chord. So over the 4, it now becomes 5-sharp-4-3-2-3-1. 5-sharp-4-3-2-3-1. So let me play that. You can hear what that sounds like. D chord, 5 chord, same melody. Back to the 4 chord, melody on top. 5 chord, etc. So that one's, if you want to hear it kind of embedded in a riff or a melody, like a keyboard melody, guitar melody, that's a perfect example of one. And the song blasts C right off the bat. Now you might be saying, how would I know that that's a 4 chord? Like if I just heard that chord, C, how do you know it's a 4 chord right off the bat? Because remember, the melody is telling us that it's a 4 chord. Because if it was a 1 chord, that melody would not be this. That melody would be this. If that was the melody, then C would be a 1 chord. Why? Because I'm playing 5-4, normal 4-3-2-3-1, right? Feels like a normal scale, but that is not what they're doing. What are they doing? They're playing that note. That's the sharp 4 of this, the root of the chord. Because of that, this chord cannot be a 1 chord. It is a 4 chord because 4 chords have sharp 4s. It's the only major chord in a key that contains that color note. Nice. So those are all the songs that kind of feature the sharp 4. The next song that we're going to go through doesn't really feature sharp 4. It doesn't really feature the 4 chord either. It's built around a 1 chord. This is a country song called Jersey on the Wall by Tennille Towns. And country often likes to play the 4 chord, but they don't often feature it like some of the songs that we just went through. They have it as a color in their progression, but the chord progression is usually based on one or six kind of your normal major or minor sounds. However, this song is going to use the four chord in a way that I call like an impact chord, or the term I think I learned a while ago was like, I think it was called like text painting or word painting. And what you're doing is you're using a musical idea to add emphasis or impact to a particular lyric or a particular like phrase or something that's happening in the lyrics. And this song, you'll hear it. The chorus runs, and the chorus is really just 1 and 4 in the key of C, so C, F, over and over again. But the end of the chorus where you hear like the big impactful lyric that the song is kind of written around, you'll hear a really long four chord. You'll hear a walk down actually, like A minor, G, and then a big long hold on a four chord, a big dramatic hold on a four chord where it holds, the rest of the music cuts. It's very dramatic at that moment because it's emphasizing or bringing out the lyric that's happening at that part of the song. The song's about, I think this is what the song is about. It's about a young person passing away, and the chorus is the singer talking to God in like this cutesy conversation, like, why do you do this? Why do you do that? But then the big lyric that happens at the end is, why did you let this person die? Like, it's a huge impact, and the four chord brings out the emotional element of that. So let me play this song real fast. Walk down, watch this. And why can't you stop a car from crashing? Forgive me, I'm just asking. Comes back into the song. So that lyric is the big impact lyric at that moment. And what happens to the arrangement? Everything cuts. Long four chord. It's very dramatic when it happens. And the four chord really builds the drama of that moment. Let me play just that part one more time. You can hear it. Listen to the arrangement. This is all normal, right? Percussion. But watch this. Walk down. Four chord coming up. Right? And that's the moment where that particular lyric lines up with the theme of the song. The four chord brings out the emotional element. So that's what I call using the four chord as like an impact chord, a chord that brings out an element of the text in this case, or an arrangement or something like that. So yeah, so that's that. The next batch of songs that we're going to go through are going to be a bunch of other songs that feature the four chord, but they're also going to go over a concept that I call writing around the one chord, or making one-centric melodies. So the idea behind all of the songs we're about to go through is something is happening that is written around the one chord. That could be a guitar riff. It could be a vocal melody. Pretty much all of these songs, it's going to be a vocal melody, while the progression is not necessarily a one chord. It's something else. So what do I mean writing around a one chord? What I mean is the notes of whatever's happening, guitar riff, vocal melody, are hitting the chord tones of a one chord. So 1-3-5 of a one chord, or maybe it's playing around in the pentatonic scale of the one chord, and it's not really paying attention to the chords changing in the background. It's like the melody just sounds good by itself over one chord, and then all of the harmony is different underneath. What this does is this makes the melody a very singable, palatable, and memorable melody because it's so simple. It's just based around a one chord, right? But if you do that and also play a one chord, it can sound really corny. It almost sounds like children's music, which you'll see as I'll give you some examples here in a second. So what they do, instead of making the song corny by only playing a one chord, they keep the simplicity of the melody being around a one chord, but change everything else. They play four chords, six chords, two chords, five chords to make it sound a little bit more interesting and not so corny. So this song that we're about to go through, this is a song called You Are a Tourist by Death Cab for Cutie. And it's happening in both ways. It's happening with a guitar riff. It's something like that. And then the vocal melody as well is all based around a D chord, which is the one chord of this key, the key of D. So that's happening, but the chords happening behind aren't necessarily D all the time. The D will be played, but there will be other chords happening also, but those melodies and that guitar riff are not going to change. So let me play it for you real fast. That's our D. Six, sorry. And four. Hear that riff? Constantly happening. that riff is happening all the time, even though the chords are changing. It's going one, then like six, four. The chords are changing, but that riff is not. The riff is entirely staying right here. And this riff is based on a D chord. That's 1-3-5 of D, the one of the key. So that riff is happening constantly. The vocal melody is also written around a D chord. What's the vocal melody? Right? 1-2-3-3-3-2-3 of D. If I just played that melody and held D, it would sound perfect. Bum bum ba da 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 bum. Ba da 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 bum. Sounds perfect, but it also sounds kind of boring. It sounds kind of corny as well the longer I play it. So what do? Change the chords underneath. Maybe a one chord. Ba da bum ba da bum. Six. Four. Ba da bum ba da bum. One. Notice I sang the same melody as though it was still a one chord, but I changed the harmony underneath. Let's go over another song that does this exact thing. This song's in the key of A. This is a song called 18 by Joyce Manor, and it's another kind of rock song. And what you're going to hear is, of course, it happening in the melody, but it's also happening literally with the guitar part. The guitar part plays this chord. That's just an A chord. That's like 5-1-3 of A, E, A, C sharp right here. Feels like a D chord up top. They play this even though the chord is often not A. It'll be like F sharp minor and they'll still be playing this. That's a six chord. Or it'll be D, the four chord, and they're still playing it. Watch this, I'll play this real fast. Here's the chord. Watch this, little riff coming in. They're gonna play the chord, but it's gonna be F sharp minor. The chord is actually that. Here comes the two chord, watch this. Back to the one chord on top. But it's actually a D chord, right? So they're playing, one guitar player is playing a one chord, and something else, guitar, bass or something, is playing D, the four chord. So you get this huge, like, super thick sound. Again, what are we doing? Pretending that it's a one chord when it's actually a four chord. And you can do that when you split up the roles around the band. We talked about that in the last lesson. Same exact thing with the vocal melody. If I play that, the vocal melody is this. It's like the most classic pop punk vocal melody you can think of. That's like a perfect melody over a one chord. 5-4-3-1 over and over again, right? If I just played an A chord. Right? It sounds fine, but it's starting to get boring the longer I play it. But if I play a four chord, for example. How about a two chord? Six chord. So I can move around to those different chords while maintaining that melody. The melody is catchy because it's so simple, but the tune doesn't sound corny because the harmony is different. Nice, let's keep going. This is another tune. Actually, I'm going to do this one first. This tune is a straight up like pretty much a metal band. This band's called Motionless in White, and the song's called Reincarnate, and they're going to do that exact same thing. The song is also in the key of D, so you're going to hear the vocal melody heavily singing notes of D, feeling like D major, but the progression is, of course, not D. They never even play a D chord. They never even play a one chord. It's entirely other things. This song is also a perfect example, if you're interested, of this style of like mainstream metal, where the verses are almost always the heavy parts, like very minor sounding, and then the choruses are almost always the singable choruses. They'll almost always play the four because that's just the easiest chord to write over. Like, this music is so easy to put together if you follow that structure. It's like play something minor, evil, metal sounding for the verses, and then do some singing part for the chorus and play a four chord because it's just going to be super easy to write over. So check this out. B right here. That's like the sixth chord of the key. Watch this. Four chords about to happen. That's G. Watch this. Four. Six. Five. Four. Six. Five. Four. Six. Five. Four. Five. Back to rock. Whatever it is. Right, so it's such a classic thing that these bands will do is they'll rock out, play like a heavy riff for the verses, and then the choruses are singable. How do they make the choruses singable? By playing chords like 4 chord, 6 chord, etc., and then making the vocal melody written around a 1 chord. What was the vocal melody? Remember, our key for the song is D, right? That's our 1. What's the melody? Something like that. I don't remember exactly what it is, but it's pretty much that. Imagine if I play that over a 1 chord. It's like kids bop, right? And that's not what the song sounds like. And how are they preventing that? By not playing the 1 chord. The melody is written around the 1 chord, but the progression never touches 1. It's 4, 6, 5, so it doesn't sound so corny. And obviously it's a metal band, so it's like drop tuned and stuff like that. So that adds to the not corniness, but regardless, the melody is still pretty much written around a 1 chord and is very corny sounding if you only play the chord that melody naturally fits over, which is the 1 chord. Okay, let's keep going. Got a couple more that do this exact thing. This next band is very different. This next band is called The 1975. The song is called She's American, and the song is in the key of D flat. And the progression is going to be 4-5-6, pretty much the same progression that we just heard, just in a different, slightly different order and different key and different genre. Those are going to be the songs that we're going to be, those are going to be the chords that are happening. So 4-5-6. Again, the song never plays 1. Even though the melody is 100% written around the 1 chord, you'll never hear an actual 1. It's only 4, 5, and 6. Let's listen to the melody first. Let's see what it sounds like. So very, very, again, kind of corny sounding melody if you played the chord that melody would naturally live over. So the melody is this. Right? Very, very one-centric, written around the 1 chord. Right? Sounds, again, like a kid's song because the melody is entirely written around the key, which is C sharp, even though the chords are not that. The chords are 4, 5, and 6. So right? It sounds a little bit more interesting, a little bit less corny because of how the harmony is moving around. Also, what's happening is there's like a little guitar riff going on in the background that is very much pentatonic scale of the 1 chord. So if this is our 1, it's just going like something like that. I don't know exactly the part, but that's pretty much what it is. And you could honestly, like, over this song, if you wanted to, you could just noodle around with the pentatonic scale on the 1 chord on C sharp and everything sounds good. I'm just noodling around over the song and everything sounds good. And I'm only thinking about 1 chord. I'm just thinking about the 1 chord of the key, the C sharp, even though the chord progression is not that. It's the classic 4-5-6. So that's 1975. Another song is going to be by a Japanese female pop trio called Perfume. I'm going to butcher the title of this name. So if you are of Japanese descent, I greatly apologize. The song, I think, is Furikaru Uitu Yo. Sure, I'm going with that one. All right, let's check it out. First of all, the song is in the same key as the 1975 that we just went through. So let me play you a little bit of the melody. So that's, again, written around the 1 chord. If I played that melody over a 1 chord, again, really corny, kids bop. That's not what it is, though. The harmony instead, again, never plays a 1 chord. The melody is written around a 1 chord, C sharp being the main note, but the harmony is never playing 1. It plays 4, so. So that's like 4-3-6-2-3-6. Never plays one. Check it out. 4-6-3-6-2-3-6. Right, so it doesn't sound corny. It sounds pretty awesome. It's just that melody by itself is kind of corny, but in the context of the progression, it works. Let's do one more song. This is like a good example of modern kind of American EDM. The song's not really that new. It's, you know, at this point, it's probably over 10 years old, but it's a good example of what people do these days. And this is a song called Stay the Night by Zedd. And there's a lot of stuff going on here, a lot of chords. And the melody, again, is ultra corny. If it was only played over a one chord, the melody's written around a one chord. It's one centric, like I mentioned, but because the chords are not really playing one, it doesn't sound corny. It sounds a lot more interesting. So let's check out what this one sounds like. I know that we are upside down, so hold your tongue and hear me out. I know this song also, by the way, in the key of A flat. What's the first chord of the song? It's not that, it's this, the 4 chord. That's the first chord you're hearing. So again, you might be saying, how do I know it's the 4 chord when it's just one chord? That's all that happened. The vocal melody, because what's the vocal melody playing? What is that note? Sharp 4 of the 4 chord. If I play that with the root of the 4 in the bass, if this was a 1 chord, it wouldn't be that. That's what it would be, right? Which sounds really odd in this context. So because I hear that note, I know this chord has to be a 4 chord. Even though I haven't heard any other chord in the song, I can tell by hearing the root note of the chord and the notes of the vocal melody. The notes of the vocal melody also kind of feel like they spell out a 5 chord, because this is the melody. It's really just walking down that scale. What note is this of the key? If this is our root, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it feels like they're playing just like a scale walking down to the fifth of the key. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. Right? So it's like the melody sort of written around a 5 chord, but the chord is actually a 4 chord. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. Again, why do people like the 4 chord so much? Because you can do all of these cool sounds over the 4, because pretty much everything works due to the 4 chords note hierarchy. So so again, that melody with the progression, so it sounds like this. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. So another really cool thing about this part, the progression is 4, 5, 6. And then we have this chord right here, which I'll talk about down the road. This is actually a 1 chord, right? It doesn't look like it, kind of doesn't sound like it, but it is a 1 chord. And they're using the 1 chord as like a transition to get you back into the 4 chord. It's kind of odd to think the 1 chord being used as a transition. Shouldn't the 1 chord be like a main chord? This is what I'm talking about here, where music is based on, the harmony at least, is based on the 4 and not the 1. And the 1 is actually used as a transition, right? That's how you create this sound, this heavy emphasis on the harmony being a 4 chord. So let me play this one more time, and I'll play the chords. I know that we are upside down, so hold your tongue and hear me out. I know that we were made to break, so what, I don't mind. You killed the same thing. Lights, so draw the blinds. Don't do the sparkle in your eyes. I know that we were made to break, so what, I don't mind. Different chord there at the end, that's the 2. Now, I wasn't playing the rhythm 100% correct, but who cares? So now we get into the next melody. This one is ultra corny. Let me play this melody for you. That's the melody. If I play that over a 1 chord, so it sounds like I'm watching the Teletubbies or something like that, right? It's super corny. But again, that's not the harmony at all that's happening. Instead, it's a bunch of chords. It's like 6, 5, 1, 2, 1, 4, 6, 5, 1, 2, 4. tons of chords that make that melody. The melody, again, is still easy to sing. It's still palatable, but it's not so corny when you hear it underneath all of that different harmony. So let me play this for you. Here we go. Right, so again, that melody could otherwise, if it wasn't that progression, it could sound really silly, really corny, but because that progression is different and helps kind of let those notes of the melody sit in the chords in different ways, it doesn't sound corny at all, and it sounds pretty awesome in my opinion. So yeah, that is a concept that you are going to hear so much in modern music. The melodies are written as though it's just like a one chord over and over again, but the harmony is almost never that. The harmony is focused on other chords for being one of those main chords. So hopefully all this stuff makes sense. I'm going to write down all the names of these songs for you to check them out, because most of them, at least, are really cool. Hopefully, these are some songs you've never heard before and you can dive into a little bit. But yeah, hopefully all this stuff makes sense. See you guys.